We've come northwest into Piedmont for the 12th stage of the Tour of Italy. The 146-kilometre route starts in Cuneo and finishes in Pinerolo, a town we'll be visited twice, and its Muro di Via del Principe di Acaja will also be scaled twice. In between the two visits to Pinerolo, the riders will swing west to climb up to Montorso on their first trip through the 1,000-metre barrier. The town sits at 1,248 metres, and the 8.9-kilometre climb carries a first category label with an average of 9.4%. The route may be short, but it harbours several possible pitfalls for the GC favourites.
A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group. The breakaway has now got over a minute on the pack. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed.
Boomin is off.
Some team managers mustn't appreciate the fact that there is a breakaway, given that the pack has increased its speed. The pack is putting the squeeze on the breakaway. The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway.
Kelderman goes onto the attack.
The gap is widening. It's now over 2 minutes. Look, the pack has taken its foot off the gas. The team leaders can't be too worried about the breakaway. The breakaway is not to everybody's liking. The peloton has significantly increased its speed. A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group. Looks like a few riders at the back are beginning to stall. A rider has fallen, and he's not getting back up. It looks like he'll have to abandon the race. A fall just took place in the pack. Several riders are on the ground. Oh, a rider has taken a tumble. Fortunately, nobody went down with him. A rider just withdrew. We're into the second half of the race. The riders are going to be more and more on their guard. Uh-oh, the gap is widening. It's now more than 2 minutes. The peloton seems content to let it grow. The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway. The pack's deficit is being cut back. Some team managers mustn't appreciate the fact that there is a breakaway, given that the pack has increased its speed. The riders really have to be vigilant on this cobbled section. The vibrations really take it out of you. The pace is really hot, so for the moment, we shouldn't see too many attacks. Oh my, the guys up front aren't going to be making too many friends today. We've got just one third of the race left to run. Now's not the time to give up watching. The riders are in a portion above 10%. There's now more than a minute between them. The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway. The lead over the pack is dwindling. The group is slowly thinning out due to such a frantic pace. The riders are going through a very tough portion with percentages above 10%. The pack is slowly whittling away the lead. There's a sustained rhythm at the moment. Some riders definitely won't be able to keep up. We've got 15 kilometers to the finish line. The escapees have surrendered. The pack gave them no chance. The finish line is getting close. The riders just passed the 10 kilometers road sign. You see that? You can read the pain on the faces at the back of the peloton. There's a growing number of riders left behind. Only 5 kilometers left. It's always best to be in the lead when going into cobbled sections. Breaks in the peloton can happen at any moment. There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up.
Mikel Landa has fallen. Today, the victory goes to Bauke Mollema.
The rider is down. Now for the race highlights. Thank you.